WOCA. Ocala. All right, kind of a health segment this morning. Mark Shaw is here from Dr. Juan Jordan's office down in the Villages, and I want to stress that down in the Villages. The last guest we had is in London, England, and she's written a book, which makes so it's okay. You just read her book. But a lot of times we'll have specialists and to go actually get that advice firsthand. You know, it's one thing over the internet or through a book or whatever, but when you can sit with somebody who can actually talk to you and answer questions, to know that Dr. Jordan is down in the Villages makes this really, really good. And in the studio, not on the phone, Mark Shaw is here. Mark has been helping us understand what they do down at Dr. Jordan's office in the Villages. It's everything, pretty much. Medical weight loss, if you need to lose some weight. You know, the last guest was talking about getting yourself healthier with the right eating, and I guess it goes hand in hand with losing weight. The term platelet-rich plasma is a term we learned from Mark Shaw, from Dr. Jordan's office, and of course they handle all kinds of things. Orthopedic care. Joe and Patsy are currently under the care of Dr. Jordan for their knees. People are going there for diabetes treatments. Sometimes they all work hand in hand too. Geriatric care, which is, are we knocking on that door, Robin? Geriatric?
I think so. We've got about 3 decades to go, but I think
young at heart. Oh, 3 decades. Oh, I'm good.
Yeah,
I'm glad it's not right around the corner. Good morning, Mark. How are you again?
I'm doing well. Thank you for having me.
Got a little jet lag. You said you were in where? Portland?
In Portland, yes.
Nice.
Doing seminars and working with doctors. You know, we stay on the cutting edge of anything that's new in the technology, and you know, and going through how PRP is no longer a theory-based medicine. I mean, it is now scientifically and medically proven. And at Dr. Jordan's office, I went to the seminar this weekend, obviously in Portland, but that's to, you know, keep up to date and to learn and make sure everything is, you know, if there's something new or something that works and it's even better for patients, we always try to make sure that we are on the cutting edge of that. But going through and learning our harvest system and learning even more about it and what it can do, and that's how we harvest the PRP
from someone's body. It's so fascinating to me because it's almost like it was under our noses all this time and we just didn't know how to do it or didn't even realize to look.
It is fantastic that you know, the leaps and bounds that medical science is making, and things that you know, were debilitating 10 years ago, and I mean, yeah, would leave you in, you know, rehab from knees and shoulder surgeries. And I mean, you can look in our athletes today in professional sports. They tear a rotator cuff in a shoulder, a pitcher, baseball pitcher, maybe your favorite baseball pitcher, and you look they're back on the playing field, you know, months later, instead of out for a year or a year and a half. Knee surgeries and basic tears and of muscles and all of these things that where years back you would see athletes and they would be gone for certain amounts of times. The recovery and the recuperation and the healing factors from all of this medical science now is just so much faster. So you take that and you put that into a person like myself, you, Robin, who, you know, we're not out there on the NFL gridiron or the baseball diamond and at that level,
right.
And leading our day-to-day lives, someone that deals with hip pain every single day, or for example, like Patsy and Joe, which have been dealing with knee pain, and it just became a way of life that, okay, well, every day that I wake up and that I'm going to be here, I've got this pain for, you know, that I'm going to deal with
from
9 to 5. And now, just with simple injections, is no, you don't have to deal with that any longer. It's gone.
Wow.
I mean, we're going to take care of that chronic pain. And you have patients that, I mean, you give them their life back. So it's fantastic.
And that's what's really amazing, because sometimes people, when they're in pain, they say, oh, it'll go away. They try to deal with it because they're afraid, because they don't like to hear that word surgery, but you alleviate all their fears.
Yeah, because and very commonly in our practice, what we see, and when it comes in, when patients come into the practice, is you're seeing, you know, even looking outside the window here, you can watch people and how they walk, and you'll see people, you know, favoring a knee or walking sideways. I mean, this is not a visual medium, obviously, for you know, our listeners, but I mean, you, that person that you see that comes walking in and is hobbling along, and you know, oh, how you doing today? Yeah, I'm fine. And you know, that, because that becomes a way of life. You wind up accepting those things when that's not normal. That's not, doesn't have to be the way of life. It's just that, you know, people get used to of living under that, you know, that emblem of pain, and it just it doesn't have to be, and that's what we do down at Dr. Jordan's office. So
I sort of have a double question for you. It partially is about diabetes, and the question itself comes from a conversation we had with somebody else about diabetes, how diabetes can reduce the function of the capillaries, and so reversing that, if it's possible, and I think you've said it is, You can increase the function of the capillaries, and therefore blood and oxygen can get to like in your eyes, for example, the little tiny blood vessels.
Right, and what's more prominent than that is that, you know, how you get neuropathy in the lower extremities and everything from the circulation, or the lack thereof, and that is, yes, Dr. Jordan obviously treats diabetes medically with medications and what he can do to help you. He has also, obviously, now we do and have been doing for some time the medical weight loss program, because if you're diabetic, it is a very serious disease. And you know, it is very scary. And Dr. Jordan and other doctors, you know, their ability to treat and to work with that is using medications. Well, Dr. Jordan goes a step beyond in his office and says, you know, okay, I'm going to treat it with medications, of course, but I'm also going to let you know that, you know, through our weight loss program and eating correctly and eating fruits, vegetables, and the medical weight loss program and the lifestyle change that we help you get on, you know, we're also taking diabetic patients from 11 A1Cs to, you know, 6.1 and 6.5 and dramatic, and basically putting their diabetes under control with simply the diet and the weight loss program. And that allows Dr. Jordan to then start backing off of the actual synthetic and the medications that he's having to give those patients.
And so then does the pain of neuropathy go away?
That varies from patient to patient. We utilize the PRP and stem cell for the neuropathy and the pain that the patients are having. We have an actual program that's set up with, you know, a rebuilder that uses electric stem to rebuild the circulation and the nerve endings in the lower extremities, as well as we're using the stem cell and the PRP that allows the body basically to start healing that area and start returning that circulation and feeling to those areas. So kind of like, you know, I mean, if you were to take your finger and wrap a rubber band around it, okay, the tip of your finger, you know, it starts turning blue.
Right, for sure.
And it'll start to get a little painful. And then it goes numb.
And then eventually you lose it, right?
Right, and then eventually you lose it. So imagine having that there for some time, and now we're going to take that rubber band off, okay? So those sensations are start coming back, and what we've noticed with our neuropathy patients is, okay, then you start to get feeling in there. Then like the needles that you feel in your feet, and then it starts to come back, and then you start to regain actual feeling. So it goes one way, and then as we tear that rubber band off, you know, it comes all the way back to, you know, a functioning the number one patient that I think about, you know, Marianne, she absolutely had neuropathy and was on a very powerful drug. I actually even had her on this show with us, and she's still doing wonderful.
Right,
she had
right,
a series
right.
of PRP and stem cell
right.
and has returned feeling to her leg that was not there, was on four.
That's right, I remember this.
Yeah. Four yeah. gabapentin a day minimum, which is a very powerful drug to help for pain. And when she actually came on the show, she had cut that to one gabapentin in the evening time when she would go to sleep, and has since basically just is foregone all the pain medication whatsoever because it's returning that feeling to her legs.
We know of a couple who had a little girl. She's 12 now. Mm-hmm. And when she was born, she has limited motor movements. Her body can't hold her up without help. But she doesn't have any sensation in her lower extremities that will give her feeling that she's touching the ground.
Right. That tactile feeling is very, very important.
Can
to be
you
able
help
to,
her?
To stand up. Yeah. That's very similar to what Mary Ann Donahue had. She
yeah.
was on this show. She came on. She discussed everything. Parts of her life had been taken away, like tennis and different things that are activities that tactile you take for granted. Being able to feel the bottom of your foot hit the ground,
mm-hmm.
and you know your balance, and so you know these things slowly are returning to her that she can do. I would say that I would have that little girl. You know, come in, see us at the office, have our physicians, you know, take a look at her and determine a treatment plan and a course of action for her because stem cells and platelet-rich plasma is becoming the way of medicine. I mean, it is phenomenal, mm-hmm. the changes that we see in patients in our office with these injections.
That would be an absolute godsend.
Oh my gosh, that would be a miracle. Mm-hmm. Is there any homework? I'm guessing it doesn't all happen in Dr. Jordan's office. I'm guessing you and he talk to the patients, and we have to do our part on when we're out there. We can't be, you know, stuffing junk in our mouths anymore, right?
In the weight loss program, yes. And with the platelet-rich plasma, I mean, it is, there are a few criteria. I mean, smoking and nicotine obviously is a dramatic reduction in the body's delivery system to put those platelets or stem cells for that matter into an area.
Alcohol too?
Alcohol, not as much, no. Alcohol does not cause the damage that, say, smoking does,
mm-hmm.
Which prevents, you know, the platelet-rich plasma from working. Cortisone and steroid shots, where they are effective, if you were to have a steroid shot, say, in your knee, it would be a minimum of 3 months before we could go in there and treat that, because the exact reaction biologically that we're looking for, meaning to have those platelets come in and cause an inflammatory response, which is how our body heals itself, okay, the steroid itself is causing the exact opposite of that to happen. Use of NSAIDs like Advil or ibuprofen, okay, it's an anti-inflammatory, okay? So it prevents your body from having that inflammatory response. Now, where that helps decrease pain,
uh-huh.
it also prevents the PRP from actually taking
place. Oh, my
gosh, place.
That makes sense. And
wow.
It just, I never heard it that way before.
Right.
Joe had said something interesting the other day, that when a person is being treated and the stem cells are going there to correct whatever's going on, if you get a cold or something and it gets in its lungs, it seems to be diverted to the lungs. So the body is, it's a really marvelous mechanism. It's very complex.
True. Now, for example, if you have a patient that, you know, if you have a patient that gets sick underneath, you know, during the treatment or during your treatment, yes, more than likely what prevents and causes the PRP not to work during that would be the medications that you would be on. Say, for example, if you were to go out and, you know, get bronchitis or pneumonia or anything else, I mean, it's kind of like your body hits, you know, hits the fire alarm button and says, okay, every, you know, we're going to pour cold water on everything to make sure that the fire's out,
mm-hmm.
but you're causing damage to the couches and to the carpet and to all of that kind of stuff, right. too. Does that make sense? And so it doesn't
that's
really...
That's a good metaphor, yeah.
Yeah, that's what we're doing. You know, forget worrying about the carpet for right now. Just make sure that the, you know, the whole body doesn't burn down, mm-hmm. right? Yeah, yeah. So that, in essence, and those medications that doctors give you, I mean, because, you know, bronchitis turned into pneumonia or something along those lines, that's a very serious. And so that has to be taken into consideration first, meaning medications to prevent, you know, that from spreading or getting worse or happening to you. You know, yes, we like to make sure that you have no fevers, you have no active cancer, non-smoker, no NSAIDs.
What's an NSAID?
An NSAID is an ibuprofen.
Okay.
So it's a non-steroidal, okay, anti-inflammatory, and it basically, it's your Advil, ibuprofen.
Okay.
Tylenol is one that is not. Tylenol is not an NSAID.
Oh, so you can take that.
Yeah.
So
aspirin?
A baby aspirin. But no, there are, and there's some medications for patients with hypertension and blood pressure problems that, you know, thin the blood, it makes it obviously not necessarily a candidate for PRP. These are the things that we check out and that we look at and that we verify that you are a, you know, when you, that's why our first consultation is completely free.
Wow, that's
doesn't pretty, cost anything.
Do you know, I think I'm trying to relate to it. I think I have one. Maybe I shared this with you, maybe not, but a year ago or so, I had this unhealing ulcer on my front of my left leg. Mm. Wasn't going away no matter what I did. And it got infected and it hurt real bad. Long story short, when I went to a doctor and finally had it under her care, mm-hmm. what she would do on a weekly basis was she would scrape it, actually make it bleed.
Yes.
And so the fresh blood is what was actually healing it.
That's when she's causing that, she's basically kind of doing an inflammatory response and making that happen so that the body registers that. If you were to cut yourself on your arm, it sends blood there, and then eventually it scabs over, and then skin, and then everything else, because mm-hmm. the brain hardwire is, it registers, okay, well, that's a trauma, okay, and when that happens, I need to send, you know, stem cells and regenerative properties to that area, that's because amazing. You can't walk around for the next 30 years with a hole in your leg.
Yeah, right.
It allows infection to get in and everything else, so it's the body's job. It's going, okay, I got to seal that up and clean that off. So as she was doing that, is basically ringing a bell, I guess, you know, Pavlov's response. You ring the bell, dog comes in and it's eating, it starts out. Okay, so she's sitting there scraping and ringing that bell, and the body is continuously sending those regenerative properties to that area.
Wow. Is that similar to what happens with PRP?
PRP in a much, much faster and much more dramatic. I mean, your body, you know, let's say it sends, you know, platelets and regenerative properties of 100,000 there, you know. What we're producing with PRP is in the millions.
Like, that's amazing, isn't it?
1.5 million
really
per microliter that we are, you know, regenerative properties that we're putting into a knee, you know, versus, you know, your body's natural healing. I mean, you cut yourself, it takes a week, right? 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Yeah.
Okay? Because it's certainly sending regenerative and healing properties there. Okay, or you sprain your ankle, it takes a certain amount of time to heal. Well, if I flood that area with all of those healing properties, like 1.5 million of them, then it's going to do so faster. Many hands make the workload light. So if I have one person building a house, it takes them a long time.
A long time.
But if I have, you know, 500 people building a house, everybody's putting in a nail all at one time.
Yes,
it goes much, much faster.
Yes.
And it's really wonderful how you're sitting here with us explaining everything, taking your time, and that's the same demeanor that your patients will see with you when they come visit you, not just for the first time, but all the time.
That's correct. Our first visit is completely free to any of the patients, for them to come in and for us to take the time and sit down and have that discussion with them, because that's... that is sometimes lost in the medical field, and that's why at Dr. Jordan's office we get phenomenal results, is we take the time to look at every avenue and go, okay, here is the best course of action in order for you to get results on this unwanted health condition that you've had for 10 years, 5 years, whatever that may be.
The phone lines are open. If you have a question for Mark, we would love for you to call the number 622-9622. That's our number here at WOCA right now. Mark is representing Dr. Juan Jordan down in the Villages. So if you've been listening and you've, if you or somebody you know has got diabetes, got some joint pain, knee pain, any kind of orthopedic issues, if you're up there in age and you know it's not like it was when you were younger, there's things that can be done to help you get along. The platelet-rich plasma is almost like a miracle procedure, I guess you would say. And weight loss, also medical weight loss. If you have questions about any of those, please call 622-9622. And before we wrap it up, we'll give you the number down at Dr. Jordan's office. We're up against the break. Just a real quick one. We'll be right back.
The weather is brought to you by MyFWC.com. Safe boating is no accident. On this Thursday, times of sun and clouds and becoming breezy. With a shower or thunderstorm in spots later on, the high 86 to 90. Mostly cloudy Thursday night with a couple of showers and even a heavy thunderstorm around, especially late at night. The overnight low 62 in the northern part of the zone to 71 at the south. Friday, cloud and a shower or thunderstorm giving way to some afternoon sun, high 75 to 79. From the Florida Weather Center, I'm Joe Lundberg.
Mother's Day is the 14th, and you know what that means. Symphony Under the Stars at the Ocala Golf Club, 3130 East Silver Springs Boulevard. Bring a picnic and enjoy food specialties, fabulous music from the Ocala Symphony Orchestra, and fireworks. It'll be very dark after the fireworks, so be sure to bring a flashlight. Adult advance tickets are $20 and $25 at the door. Children 6 to 17, just $5. This is a wonderful way to spend Mother's Day evening with the family. Gates open at 5:30, and the concert begins at 7 o'clock. See you there.
All right. Mark Shaw is here from Dr. Jordan's office. We got about 4 minutes left, and I think the bottom line here is go make an appointment. It costs you nothing to sit and talk with Mark and go down to the Villages. It's a short drive, and perhaps something you've been living with for a while you don't have to live with it.
I would say just get the information at least,
and ask about the payments also, because I know that you have some plans that are not exactly the same as other doctors.
And many some of our patients admit, perhaps, I mean, you're diabetic or anything else, your insurance does cover, and Dr. Roden accepts all kinds of insurances and is very well versed in that. And the point being is, set the appointment. It's free to you. You don't even know if it's going to cost you a dime. It may not. It may be covered completely underneath your insurance, the course of action that you need to take. And it may be, okay, well, this procedure, hey, you've been dealing with this the past 10 years, and for a small amount of money that can even be financed and broken out into an easy payment plan for you with no interest and no credit checks, it gets rid of it forever for you, and you may be up against some serious decisions like surgeries. And I've had many of my patients who have come and said, I'm overweight and they won't take me for surgery. What can you do to help me? I had one lady who has lost 54 pounds with us on a weight loss program, but both of her SI joints literally got it to, yep, which is right in your back, on the back side of your hip, just above your rear end, your glutes, right there in the lower back, on either side, of the hips. And it caused her to where she couldn't exercise, she couldn't get up, she couldn't move around because it was so excruciatingly painful. She's been our patient for some time now, and now is walking, exercising, lost 54 pounds on our weight loss program, out of pain.
That's good news.
Yeah. Is enjoying life again. But point being, on the road to recovery and healthy, and she has more to go, but she's doing fantastic. But if you never get off the couch or make the phone call or even take the time to come down to the office and say, hey, I'd like to know about this.
Right.
You don't have you're living with something that you may not even have to. You're not even getting the information. So make yourself educated, make yourself aware of what's going on with your own health for sure. And, like I say, give us a call, April or Desiree. They're wonderful girls right there at the front desk. They will get you scheduled in to speak with myself, Charles Brooks, or even Dr. Jordan. And it is, the first consultation with you is completely free. It's not going to cost you a thing. The telephone number to reach them is 352-633-633 0473. That is our office, and myself included, I'll be there as well. I guess I didn't include myself in the group. But
and where exactly in the village? The villages is huge. Where are you in the villages?
Yes, we are right across from on 441, right across from Target, and right at Office Depot and Outback, which is right there, and we're directly across in the Rolling Oak Shopping Center.
Mark, thank you for coming in and doing this. And for the listeners, this has been recorded. It will be put up on the internet as a podcast. So share this with somebody who will benefit from it. And usually we get that done by 2 o'clock each afternoon. Dr. Mark Morshaw, thank you for coming in.
Yep, thank you for having me.
And Dr. Yordan, if you're listening, thank you. We'll be right back.
News Radio. I'm Lillian Wu. Republican leaders optimistic about their